looking good, boys.
Yep.
Oh, and he's got him with the gap, boys.
Awesome.
Keep your eye on it. Don't stop. Yeah, right there. It's a black.
It's a big marlin, bro.
This full feature-length episode on Ultimate Fishing involves me out fishing in my Stabycraft boat. My big boats, in fact my small boats, I designed myself. I packed them full of features for fishing, and people just love checking out my boats and what I'm doing with these amazing boats. And in this episode, we give a couple of fans an opportunity to come out. We quite often will do that, just put out the call on Facebook, hey, who wants to come fishing? So there's a note, if you don't already follow ITM Fishing, Ultimate Fishing and Matt Watson on Facebook, here they are, there'll be some logos around here. You want to follow those. And you could be just like these guys. They each had a wish of a particular fish they wanted to catch. They'd never met each other, they'd never met me, but I threw them on the boat and off we went to go out to some of my spots, and we had a whole lot of fun putting them onto the fish of their dreams. A couple of average Joes, followed by not such an average Joe. In fact, Joseph Parker. Who is heavyweight champion of the world, boxing champ, great guy, and loves his fishing. Fishing for me is all about a diverse bunch of people, sharing a good time and sharing some of my skills and knowledge. So enjoy this episode. Hopefully you enjoy it almost as much as they did. And of course, don't forget to follow us on social media, and it could be you that's coming out fishing with me next time. One of the things I love about fishing is sharing some incredible moments with people, just being part of someone's experience when they catch the fish of a lifetime. So I thought I'd throw it out there on Facebook and see if anyone wanted to come out and catch their fish of a lifetime with me. I did that just a couple of days ago. Well, hundreds and hundreds of people came in with some pretty amazing requests, and I had to pick just one of them. And I couldn't pick one, so I've picked two. So I've picked Mike and Craig. Now, Mike, tell us, what fish is it that you want to catch today?
Mate, big old blue nose, eh? Big old blue nose.
Blue nose?
Yeah. Don't get the chance to come out deep, eh?
Yeah, never caught one?
Nah, never caught one. Never been deep fishing, actually.
What about you, mate? What are you after today?
A marlin and a yellowfin.
Marlin and a yellowfin. Okay. Well, I thought it was marlin or yellowfin. It was going to make it easier for me.
See, we're just coming out of a bit of a gutter here. Sitting up on top is all of this fish here. Now that doesn't look like much on the screen, but that's 20 metres deep. Now that's not actually the blue nose that we're looking for. That's the stuff that they're feeding on it. But there are a few sort of targets out around the edge of it, which I can see on my zoom side here. And the trick now will be working out which way the current's going so we can drop. And hopefully we can get Mike's blue nose early on so we can get onto Craig's yellowfin or marlin.
You ready to drop?
Yeah, okay, go starboard. Stand by port and go port. Okay, Mike, you used one of these guys before, mate?
No.
Okay, so we're just letting that crash all the way down to the bottom. The trick is 310 metres here, mate, so over your head. I mean, that's one of the reasons why most people don't get to fish for blue nose. They're extremely deep, you need a good sounder. Helps if you've got an electric reel, because it can be hard work hauling in 310 metres of line. But what you want to do as it's getting closer is actually pick it up, okay? Because you want to be able to really feel it hit the bottom.
Right.
Oh, blue nose. Blue nose would be a good way to start. Is that at the bottom? There you go. Lift your rod tip up, mate. Oh, well, Craig, you might have caught
Mike's fish.
Yeah, you might have caught Mike's fish. How would you feel if he caught your marlin? We've got the technology here, mate. I know it's strenuous work catching these blue nose and all. Oh, look at this weather, I'm just so amped up. I'm amped up for these guys. Jimmy. Oh, look at that.
It's a fatty too.
Okay, now we've got to be careful with the teeth on these guys. Jeez, that's a fat Jimmy. Well done, bro.
The size of the teeth on it.
Yeah, mate, check out those, all right. Now just watch any head shakes, because if those teeth, I've had them, if they brush against you, they're going to slice you open, mate. But, mate, that's some fine eating. A cousin of the barracuda, but unlike the cuda, these things are real good eating, mate. That big old mouth.
Bit of weight in it, eh?
Yeah. I'm taking you've not caught one of those before?
Never seen one in my life.
Sweet, that'll do better than a marlin, mate, honestly. Better than a marlin or a tuna, mate. If we catch one of those, it'll be a bonus. Okay, let's move back up and get ready to drop again, eh? We'll get that guy on ice. Okay, mate, go. Jim, this is the first 4 years as well, I take it?
Yeah.
That can just be the trouble though, when you're targeting blue nose, you might have to catch a few of these. Not that there's anything wrong with catching Jim fish. nothing wrong with catching those. But still, the mission is to get you your blue nose. But these jimmies can give us happy in the meantime. Right, we've got another one over here, have we? Oh yeah, smaller one here. Beauty, it'll be a nice eater though. Okay. A bit better, is it? Might be the blue dog, hopefully.
Oh yeah, that loaded up.
That loaded up. Another gym banger. Another two jimmies. Double whammy, boy.
Synchronized swimming.
Oh, that bottom was a biggie. Well done, mate. Right, didn't you guys say that the fish you really wanted to catch was a big gem fish? All right, mission accomplished. A little bit harder, is it? You gotta be careful, mate, that fuse is blown. You're gonna have to manually do it. Oh, and you're hooked up over here too. You fellas gonna have to wind them in manually. Enjoy it, boys, enjoy it. It's a bit of a shame that, you know, it happens time to time, the old fuse blows, but I wouldn't want to rob you of the pure pleasure of actually fighting your fish, you know? It's all part of it, mate. It's all part of it, fellas.
How much longer you got to go, Mike?
Don't even want to think. Don't even want to think. Sheesh. Arms are really sore.
Hard work, eh, buddy? Hard at work, men. Watch yourself. Well, that's starting to float a little bit, is it?
Yeah.
That's promising. Got colour? Can't quite make it out yet. It's a blue nose, brother! Yeah, it's a blue nose, bro, and it's a nicey too, boy! That's a nice one. Yeah, boy. All right. That's the thing, we waded through those jimmies, and that is a nice blue nose to get yourself off the bat with. Let's pop this in his gob. I'm pretty sure you want to see this on the deck. It's just about to be, right? There you go. There you go, mate.
Oh, nice. Jeez,
mate. Bring it in. Yes. See? Oh, jeez. Far out. Caught a few of these now, I never get sick of it, but it's always better when you're with someone who really wants to catch one. Well done, got them on the blue nose rig, and one little difference we've got here, we've got a little flashing light, you can pick these up from hunting and fishing, and slightly smaller circle hooks, the VMC circle hook, all the same than I use for pooka for the blue nose, and that's because we use smaller baits sometimes, but you beauty, that's going in the bin. Reckon you might want to catch one now, eh?
Too right.
Yeah. We might do one more drop then, eh, fellas? And it's probably about now that I should tell you. No, I won't tell you. I'll tell you later. And good, you're not too big a fella as well, mate, the fish. Yeah, it's like when you got the ABs on board, they made everything look small.
Oh, man. I'm stoked.
Oh, we've got one target.
Yeah.
Looking good, boys.
Yep.
Oh, and he's got him with the gap, boys.
He's got it, boys.
Keep your eye on it. Don't move. Don't stop.
Yeah, right there.
It's a fucking black.
It's black.
It's a black. It's a black. We
We put the word out on our Facebook page that we wanted to help someone catch their dream fish. And from the hundreds of responses, we selected Craig, who wants to catch his first game fish, a marlin or a yellowfin tuna, and Mike, who wants to catch his first blue nose.
Bit of load there, eh? Might have another blue banger there, bro.
Well, we've completed half the mission. Mike has got his blue nose. But before we move on to Craig's dream fish, we're doing one more drop to see if we can catch another tasty blue nose to take home for dinner.
Nah, Dim.
Leave him in the water, mate. We're going to let him go. We'll get a bit of angle. We're getting some angle.
What do we got? What do we got?
Looks like you got yourself another blue nose, brother. You've double whammied it. Good stuff, bro. Between the gemfish and blue nose, we've got heaps to eat, eh, guys?
Heaps.
So, marlin and tuna time.
Yeah, mate.
Yep.
I'm all good with that.
Yep. Yeah. These, I'm just going to get us idling in the right direction while we get set up. We're going to run that on that flat line there. Just going to give that a quick touch up. So now it's time to get Craig here, his marlin or tuna. We're just going to set up a lure spread. So I've got a selection of lures here. This one you can see is well battered. This is a Williamson lure. Because it's a calm day, we're going for an angled face. So that's going to have quite an active sort of an action. And I find that these colours, these Lumo green colours, lots of tuna, lots of striped marlin on there. So that'll work quite nicely in on one of my flat lines. But we were lucky enough to see a couple of yellowfin come in yesterday, and I cut the guts open and had a look inside them, and I found a whole bunch of squid. And so why not chuck this guy out? This is just a basic squid shell with an old film canister on top and a washer. Caught lots and lots of marlin, and just the other day I caught a yellowfin tuna on one. So that's going out. And then we've got a slender bait fish profile. So this one will be going out on the riggers, because generally speaking, you have your smaller lures further back and your bigger lures closer up. Follow all that?
Yep.
Good. Right, now I've got this guy here, which is the Rapala X-Rap 30. Now, it's a diving minnow. So what it does is this bib here scoops up some water and it dives down up to 30 feet or 10 meters below the surface, which is ideal for your yellowfin tuna. You're not likely, or I've never ever had a marlin bite on one of these guys, because the marlin really want that surface activity. This guy diving down, perfect for yellowfin. That's your spread all set good now, Craig. Hopefully it'll mean that you're gonna get that first marlin or tuna. We've actually had a bit of a good run lately. Well, there you go, I have had a good run lately, and I've taken my GoPros out last few weekends and caught a couple of mates their first marlin, which was just awesome to catch on the GoPros. So you can actually check all of that out by going to ultimatefishing.tv, where you'll see all of the up-to-date action. And of course, it's coming up constantly in our Facebook feed where these guys here found us. So get on there, like us up, and you'll get to see all of our latest action
as it happens.
So you get a few gannets working up, and it's like a boat magnet. All of these boats have been attracted here. But isn't it great to see all of these people out here with a real chance of catching a magnificent fish like a yellowfin tuna? They're a real treat. Too good for a can, I tell you. Way too good to be in a can. Which way are the gannets tracking? Going that way, eh? Oh, here we go, right next to us. He went in on bait. Looks like pillies. Oh, and dolphins here too. The yellowfin run with dolphins. Boys, there's gonna be tuna here. Now these couple of marks that we've got here, they are yellowfin tuna. I'm convinced of it. Just big, thick arches like that. And they're shallow enough that we should be able to raise them with the lures. So I'm just gonna come around. Looks like a boat stopped here. They may have even hooked up. But what I can do to see where they are, touch them and put a point, and that point goes onto my plotter, and I'll mark both of them, and
and that way I can go right over the top of where they are. Two marks right back there on our track, and hopefully we'll be able to raise them up.
She's on with them. Ducking and diving.
Start winding your fishing. Use the rod, yep, keep everything tight. Turn that clicker off. Keep everything nice and tight, okay? Yeah. Always needs to be tension. Okay, I'm just chucked the live bait out as well because we're just coming to this big area of activity. The gannet started diving, and what do you know, it's the Rapala that's gone off. Okay, wind that live bait in. We're gonna switch the fish to the other side of the boat. Okay, up and over the motor. Make sure you stay clear of the motor. Okay, I'm gonna take control of the helm out here.
There's some weight on there.
Yeah, okay, that's right. It's nice and smooth, mate. Nice and smooth. That gas just there, Julian. Nah, it ain't a skippy.
Yeah. Nah, she's nodding a bit.
Yeah, I can see it down there, mate. Okay, it's your yellowfin tuna, brother.
Awesome.
It is your yellowfin tuna.
Yeah,
okay, but we haven't caught anything yet. Just keep everything nice and smooth. Okay, I'm going to get you to come forward just a little bit. Okay, keep winding, just keep winding, mate, just keep winding. Yeah. Get ready in case I've got to let go, okay? I don't want to pull too hard with these little hooks. It's going to pretty fast. There's your yellowfin tuna, bro.
Awesome.
Oh, and he's got him with the gap, boys! Yellowfin tuna!
Awesome.
He's done it, bro! Hey, Beauty, you did it. You got your fish, bro. And it was the Rapala that did it. Good gas shot, bro.
Shot, mate.
How's that, Mike? Shot, bro.
Yeah,
boys. Yeah, boys.
Awesome, mate.
Yeah, boys.
Look, I'm shaking.
Putting it out.
I just seen the tuna come right through.
Okay. Just chuck that in the bin, and I'm going to get up there and start casting, okay? Whereabouts, Jules?
Straight.
Okay, straight. It's in gear. Yeah, just close the lid. We'll worry about him later. The motor's in gear. You got to drive for me, bro.
Yeah, mate.
Chuck that live bait out, Julian. Yep. And if you mark anything down, even try a jig. Oh, this is how we fish for them over in Mexico. Find the workups and get a stick bait out. And it would just be the sickest thing in the world to get a yellowfin crash my stick bait now. Squirrels over that way. Go, come around to starboard. Okay, up to trolling speed, bro. I'm gonna leave this stick bait right up the front. Sorry, I'm shouting. I'm gonna leave the stick bait right up the front here, so if we see those yellowfin again, boom, we can flick the stick bait into them. That is exciting. That is so cool that it's happening in New Zealand. Yellowfin tuna are back. Sashimi tan.
Yeah, got my yellowfin. I can scratch that off the bucket list now.
Oh well, let's just add marlin to it.
Yeah.
Or bigger yellowfin.
Or bigger, yeah. No, I won't complain about that.
That's the thing with fishing. It is the cup that can never be filled.
Yeah.
Doesn't matter what you catch, there's always something greater. There's nothing like your first time, they say, hey, mate?
Yeah, man, the old adrenaline was going.
Nice work, bro.
Hey, mate.
What's that?
I said, that's just made my day.
Yeah, boys.
On for another.
I think this one might be an albacore or a skippy or something small, eh? Best case scenario is it's a nice little wee tasty yellowfin. But I'm picking it so like an albacore or even a skippy. What have we got? We've got a yellowfin, grab the gaff! Grab the gaff, we've got a yellowfin! Oh no, it's a big albacore. No, it's a big albacore. But it's still all the same. We want that puppy. Got the gun. Oh, nice big albie. Just don't. Easy, mate.
Get line,
don't, just. Getting schooled by a little bloody albacore. Okay, I'll grab the leader, mate. There's no panic to get it in, all right?
Yeah,
just walk to me.
Yeah.
Oh, it's a big albacore. Take your time, bro. Take your time to get a nice shot.
Another first.
Good. There we go, mate. That's a nice big albacore. Yeah, bro, that's a double.
Another first for me.
That's another species. Yeah, boy. That's a nice size albie for up these ways. Chicken of the sea, they call that stuff.
Chicken
of the sea. Just while we've got him on the gaff, if you pass that knife, we'll hold him over the side. Do you want to hold him over the side first, please, Julian? And I'll show you what we'll do is we'll bleed him. Okay, with the albacore, just get your knife in right on that line there, and that is just going to gush. And that makes them so much better eating if you can get that blood out of them. I'll do the same on the other side.
They've got big petrol fins, eh?
Yeah, they have. What they use these pick fins for, so they have that there and it recesses right in so they're a torpedo.
Yep.
Then when they want to do a sharp turn, whack, they just whack that pick fin out and they whack, turn on a dime, mate, to catch their prey. They stop, bah. Awesome. So they're the most maneuverable of the turners. And well done, that's another one. The Rapala's doing it for us today.
Another first.
And we're going to eat like kings, men. We're going to eat like kings. Oh, look at the outside of the boat. Okay, let's get this fish carved up. She's the you beauty sashimi.
I've never eaten raw fish.
Oh, you know you've got to eat the heart too, eh?
Me?
Yeah, you bought it.
Don't think so.
Yeah, I've never got to eat the heart.
So I've got to eat that.
Right, it's delicious. You're going to love it.
What if I throw up?
Oh, you throw it, it'll be a waste, mate. You won't throw up, mate. It's not even bloody, eh? I'll go your halves. So you chop this aorta bit off, because that's quite chewy. Okay, mate, you ready?
No.
Don't. There you go.
I'm not gonna eat it. It's disgusting.
It'll give you the mojo of the fish. It's not disgusting, mate. It's beautiful. It's like sweet. Hey?
It's different.
Yeah, different. This is a guy who's never eaten raw fish before. Straight to the heart. Yeah, boy.
Caught it or got to eat it, I suppose.
Good. Well, we didn't get the marlin today. We did get Micah's blue nose and Craig's yellowfin. But I did show the guys some tips and tricks on how to catch marlin on trolled lures.
The hook always goes facing up, okay? So we've just got to twist it and we're stiff rig.
And just weeks later, Mike went out and put them to practice catching his first marlin. So if you want to give it a go yourself, you can see exactly what I showed Mike, as well as all the basics of marlin fishing, right from spooling up through to hooking up. And it's all online for free at ultimatefishing.tv.
Cheers for that, Craig. We're looking pretty spick and span out here now. So you guys are heading home with a bit of fresh fish and hopefully learned a few skills too, because of course, as they say, you know, if you give a man a fish, you feed him for a day, you teach a man to fish.
For a lifetime.
Well, he's probably going to neglect his family, skip out of work and drink lots of beer on a boat. But hopefully you picked up some skills. Anyway, see you in the morning with some new anglers, some new challenges and hopefully some more results like we got today.
I love sharing the thrill of fishing with people.
Oh, look at this weather, I'm just so amped up.
And I get a real kick from seeing people achieve their fishing goals. So we took out a couple of guys that follow us on Facebook to help them catch their dream fish. Mike caught his first blue nose.
Hey, it's a blue nose, bro! Bring it in!
And Craig, his first yellowfin.
That's just made my day.
Today, I have a new bunch of guys that are equally as excited as I am about getting a whole new fishing experience.
So we've got another crew on board this morning, another set of challenges for us to try and catch these guys their dream fish. And so we've got David here, welcome aboard David.
Hey.
We've got John, and John's brought his brother along.
I'm Joe. John's brother. Joe.
Yeah, okay, so
another lively crew. I'm feeling the enthusiasm already, and these guys are just fizzing about catching kingfish. So we've got a bit of a wash rock behind us. We're gonna start with a stick bait. Julian's rigging up so we can catch some live baits, and Julian and I are gonna be going all out to catch these guys, the kingfish. That's Joseph Parker. Sorry, I couldn't help myself.
What's that?
So it's like a popper, like a surface lure.
Okay.
So when you pull up at an area and you're not sure, like there's not a lot of bait fish, cast us a few times, and they don't always eat the stick bait, but they'll raise, like if we raise a kingfish, well then we can catch live baits or throw jigging or other things or cubing them up. And then other times they just come and smash the stick bait anyway, so which is the best way to catch them, because you get to see it. So. Have you fished this recently, Julian?
Yeah. Yeah, normally on an incoming tide, I'd go on that the other corner from where we are, but give it a couple of tucks there.
Let's do one this way. Got him on, kingies. Another one. There you go, Joe. Here, bro, grab this.
What's this?
Kingy.
Yeah.
Oh. There you go. Welcome along. You got a kingy on there.
I don't know, I'll wind it.
Just lift the rod. Yeah, and just wind as you go down.
Okay.
Fish is right here. Hang on, here. Yeah, he's right here. Stop there. Yes, stop winding there. There you go, it's this little guy. So this is a nice little one to warm up with anyway.
So these are the ones that you're...
So, what we're after, pretty much, this is why it's probably a good stop here. One of these, but as big as me.
Fuck.
Yeah, boy.
There's a little different one on the left, but...
Yeah. You'll get used to it. Quiet the rods, that we've got. There you go. Released them perfectly. That's why we flattened down the barbs on the hooks.
Yeah.
So we can let them go easily. Yep, that's what we're after, but they're just little guys here, so...
You caught one as well? Oh, did you miss one, or was it...?
No, I hooked one. Oh, on that little panel.
Yeah. Okay, so what we'll do is we'll go and see if we can find some big ones of those, eh?
Sweet.
Some big bad ones of those. I've got to stop bringing all these big guys on my boat. They make the fish look small. So first up, we've got to catch some bait. So we're starting with a couple of little wee lures, just a little fly, and a little wee soft plastic or a little metal jig, and we're just going to be trolling them around the point here, trying to catch some kahawai. Because if we can get a big kahawai, the kingy that eats it is going to be well. It'll be worthy of the big fella that's going to have to pull it in. We need some bait, we need some bait. Well, Tom's are pretty tough at the moment. It's hard to catch bait, so we're going to burly up, and hopefully we can burly up some kahawai, or even better, the blue kōhiru, the elusive blue kōhiru.
So we're just attracting all the...
Yeah, we're trying to attract some kahawai, or even better, blue kōhiru. They're like the ultimate live bait. They're a little tuna.
Oh, a little tuna?
Yeah, they look like a mackerel, but they're actually part of the tuna family. And they are wicked to eat, bro.
Deer raw as well?
Yeah. Yeah, they're the closest thing to yellowfin tuna that you'll actually get. Yeah. But I don't know whether I might end up in a fight with Joseph over whether we use it for a life bait or whether we eat it.
Or raw fish.
Yeah. I think you might win. Snapper. Yep. Just seen some snapper.
Decent?
Oh, would have been legal, you know, like legal snappers.
Where am I to eat it?
Come up and...
Come on, snapper, I'll eat you.
The fish are in trouble today. Everything's gonna get eaten. Have you got any polarized sunnies? I've got some spare ones, bro. I'll grab them out. They're polarized, you'll be able to see what's going on.
Oh, real? Oh, can you see down through?
Yeah. Just give the burly a bit of a jiggle every now and then.
I want to try these. Different to that.
It takes the glare away, the polar away.
We'll get a little bit of bait and we'll just get you floating a chunk back, and hopefully a kahawai or something will come up and eat it. So you just let it sort of float back down in the trail, and if it takes off, just it's a circle hook, so no big strike. You just click it in gear and you just let it come tight. Hopefully it's a kahawai. Snapper, is it? We have this trouble all the time. I get it everywhere I go. I can't get away from snapper. That snapper's actually probably legal.
It's probably edible as well.
The next legal snapper that comes on board isn't going back. Joseph's just looking at it going... I think we're going to have some raw fish pretty soon. Yeah, okay, catch another legal one, bro. We'll breakfast it. We'll have it for breakfast. Looks like another snapper. Might be breakfast.
It might be breakfast time. It might be Ricky, who knows?
Well, they got to go 30 centimetres.
27? Is it, or is it a change?
No, it's changed to 30 now.
Is it?
Yeah. Yeah, that one's 30.
I think this is 30.
That's 30.
What it used to be?
27.
It used to be 27, yeah. I mean, if you are going to have one raw, man, those little wee ones,
they're just
beautiful, yep. All right, spike him in the head then. That fish is legal, it's just that he's huge, all right? So don't write me letters. It is legal, this we're going to measure it.
We're going to measure it. It's legal.
You can chuck him in the live bait tank for now anyway.
You know, things aren't going exactly according to my plans when we're measuring snapper to see if they're 30 centimetres. But the day's early, it's early, mate. We just need that live, wicked live baits, and we're going to go to the epic kingy spot.
We've got heavyweight champ Joseph Parker on board, and we're trying to get him hooked up to a big kingfish. But before we can do that, we need a bait.
So the kahawai are being a little bit flighty, which they can be, so we've come up front here on the casting platform. We're just going to have a cast around. So you just sort of cast off to the edge of the wash and just a slow wind, Joe.
Yeah.
Or a steady wind, you know. Got him on. Right, we've got to make this bait count because they're going to be tricky to catch today by the looks. Take your time, Jules, take your time. Yeah, boy, we have a bait, we're in business. Okay, this one's ready, bro. Kingy's going to eat that and you're going to wind it in, that's the plan. And any kingfish that eats that bait is a good one, bro.
Yeah.
It's going to be a real good one.
And well, this one, you don't need a balloon.
What's that? No. We're just going to tow two of them behind the boat.
Yeah.
I've even got I'll flick on my underwater lights and they strobe and that'll attract the kingfish as well. And then, so we'll keep this one close to the boat because they'll come up to look at the lights, see that kahawai and eat it. So if you come over here, bro, I'll show you how you're going to fish this one. So you just have your thumb on the reel.
Yeah.
Okay. And if something grabs it, you'll feel it whack. And you just kind of keep your thumb in and just let it run out. Shout out and let us know so we know. And then when we say, you just slowly push that drag up. Is this 80 braid on here? 50. Okay, mate, so there you go. You're fishing. Just hold your thumb there. And I'll go along with this other bait. You going to hold on to this, David?
Yeah.
Right. That's a great big kahawai, right? And he's going to grab it, he's going to swim off with it, he's going to turn it and swallow it. Now, if you jam down on a strike, all you're going to do is rip it out of his mouth.
Right.
Okay, you're just going to let it run, and then when we say, you're going to slowly increase that drag.
So, let it run, and then when you say, slowly up.
Slowly up, okay. Yep, until it stops there. And then after that, we'll just yell and scream and jump around, all right?
Yep, sounds good.
Calmly.
Don't stroke.
Right, we better get that stick bait going. Now something's come up on the live bait there. So, hasn't eaten it, so I'm gonna try the stick bait, just in case they might wanna eat something a little bit different. Julian, do you wanna flick the underwater lights on?
Yeah.
Okay.
Here we go. Hello, just wait. Slowly up. Yeah, we got him on, Julian. We got him on. Come around here.
Yep. Right there, you're good.
Grab the gimbal belt.
Mine's coming up.
Just move us away.
Mine's...
Pull it in, right? Is it Kingy? Pull yours in and we'll I'll get you back on the rock. Under the boat, bro, it's under the boat. Ah, oh, no, busted off. Smoked us off, bro. I've got a hell bruise right in here for trying to hold that.
This one came swimming right up there.
Yeah, that's because there was a whole heap of them there chasing us. It got the ground on us. See, just went into the rocks and boff. Smashed us off. That was a big kingy, boys.
No, it looked like it. It smashed it.
Whoa.
80 pound line, boof, no match. I reckon with this gear we might be better pull him away, bro. Didn't get over him because he was leading quite nicely to start. Would us drive away. Right, anyway, better get another trace sorted.
Nice, bit of action.
Well, there you go. That's why we spend so much time trying to catch those live baits. We finally catch two kahawai, put them out, boom, get the biggie on, smashes us off, so we're down to one bait now. Anyway, we only need one. Come on, Joe.
Let's get it on.
About now we should be doing this. Woohoo! Check this bad boy out. Woo. Can you Photoshop that in? You guys are pretty clever in edit, eh? Woo! Yeah! We got him. Pull your bait in, Joe. Let's have it.
Should we eat one?
Yeah, we'll eat the bait.
We'll eat it and it'll make
it. Yeah. That'll teach him for not doing his job. We'll eat him.
We'll eat him.
Yeah.
Just cut him up.
We will. Well, something big is going to eat one of those kahawai, I guarantee you. Just might be Joseph. Right, let's get another bait rigged up then off to my good kingy spot. I've been saving it. The hard part's going to be getting a good bait. Right, here we go, slow down, bro. Nice and easy. Gotta make him count.
No, don't put it.
No, you're alright, bro. You do it. Okay, let's grab the net. So I've only got little wee hooks here. And the other problem is quite often the kingfish eats them before you can get them in as well.
Really?
In places like this.
Really?
Yeah. Or you'll be pulling your bait in and boff, they'll smoke it. I've never wanted a kahawai so much. There we go, boys. We got us a bait. The good thing about having Joe out fishing is that if we don't catch a kingy on the live bait, Joseph's going to eat the bait. So. So we're happy, mate. We're happy either way. Rightio, off to my secret kingy rock, boys. Could someone get on the helm, please? Just idle the boat in that direction to move the marlin.
There
can you see him?
Right there.
Keep your eye on it. Don't move. Don't stop. It's a fucking black. It's a black. It's a big marlin, bro. Keep pointing at him. Idle the boat that way. Somebody put the boat. Give me the. You go. There he is. There's his tail. Just slow. Someone's going to. I want someone to hold this bait while I rig it, please. We've just seen a black marlin. Keep pointing at where he was. Joe, you keep your eye on him, Joe. Can you see him again?
Right over here.
Start closing in on him. Okay.
Yeah, he was here. Buzzing.
Holy.
There, right here. See when you see the black fin, let me know.
Can you see him?
There.
Where is he?
Right forward.
Where is he, bro?
Forward.
Get in front of him and I'll pitch the bait in front of him.
That.
Where was he last seen?
There.
Can you see him?
Yeah. Right over here.
Where is he? We'll have a teaser out while we're doing this.
With all these fishes.
Oh look, chasing Sari. Okay, guys. Neutral. I've got that belly hoo. Grab that rig belly hoo out. Even the stick bait.
There he is. He's on it.
What?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's right on my bait.
Yeah, he's on the bait.
There it is. Right there.
He hasn't got it. He hasn't got it yet. How far is that? Yeah, a little bit far. About the speed's good. He came right up to the bait. He swam right up on the bait.
Joe, I'll get you to hold this again, eh, bro?
Yeah, hold this one.
Yep. Hold your thumb up just like before and just let him run if something grabs it.
Sort of massive fin, eh?
Oh, before I get too carried away, you guys keen to catch a marlin or you want to carry on kingy mission?
No, no, just, mate, keen as.
Just postponing our kingy mission just for a moment. And you see a marlin as big as the tail that we just seen, and there was a few others there as well by the looks, so we chucked that one in the tank for now, Joe.
Sorry, mate, you didn't do your job.
No.
Now you're going to get eaten by us.
Okay, we haven't got long. We've got to start heading back in. So get the teasers out and let's see if we can find that big boy. Okay, bro. You can eat him now. Well, we kind of got sidetracked from our big kingfish plan when a massive marlin popped up next to us, so we could hardly not try and catch it. Well, it didn't bite. We saw a few others. They didn't bite either. So, sorry, Joseph, we're going to have to wrap it up, mate, without that big kingfish.
All good. Good, we gave it a go.
Yeah, we did. But you do know it's all good and it's never a bad day. We can always eat the bait.
All right. Always.
I did say that something big was going to eat that kahawai. Always a good fallback over if you can eat the bait.
I was looking forward to this whole trip.
Yes, he'd been looking at that. He'd been looking at that cowboy and the live bait tank going, can I eat him now? Good luck for the next fight, bro. All the best, eh?
Thanks very much.
Yeah, we've got to get you back for that big kingy.
Oh.
That's going to happen.
Yeah. Sweet.
Director, thank you happy?
Yep, all good. Thank you. Be a good day.
You want a bit of bait?
I'm all right.
You all right? Oh, yeah, it's good too, bro. Good. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this episode. But if you want to see the most up-to-date action, including this swordfish that I'm hooked up to now that's about to jump, you can get more action for free, as well as all the tips that go with it, at ultimatefishing.tv. Or download the Ultimate Fishing app. Here we go. Oh, there he goes out there.